be here. It's been a minute since I've been here. Amen. Just for a moment. The word gospel occurs in the Bible 101 times in 93 different verses. And it's in 19 of the 27 books of the New Testament. It's mentioned the most in the book of Hebrews. I'm sorry, the book of Romans. It's 13 times. And there are several definitions that scholars give for the word gospel, but we know it as the good news of Jesus. That's how I grew up knowing it, and that's how I live by it today. Amen. And there are four gospels in our Bible: Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And they're the four gospels that we go off of. But just for a little bit, if you don't mind, I'd like to talk to you about the gospel in you.
All right.
Amen. And so when you receive the Holy Ghost, I believe God gives you two different testimonies.
Yes.
And for me is one long drug out testimony. Amen. I could tell the same testimony for 15 years and still not cover the same thing twice, but that's just how much I've been delivered from.
All right.
Amen. But I believe God gives you two testimonies. One of where He brought you from, and the other one of where He's taking you.
Amen.
All right. Amen. That's it's nice to know where God's taking you, but it's very important to know where He brought you from. Because if you forget where He brought you from, you'll let the devil take you back and you won't even know it. Amen.
Amen.
So I wake up sometimes in the morning, I remind myself where God brought me from, and I remind the devil that I'm not for sale.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
So
Amen.
In the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 1, I'm going to read just a couple of verses here. Starting with verse 5, it says, "The sun also ariseth, and the sun goeth down, and hasteth to his place where he arose. The wind goeth toward the south, and turneth about unto the north. It whirleth about continually, and the wind returneth again according to his circuits. All the rivers run into the sea, yet the sea is not full. Unto the place from whence the rivers come, thither they return again." Yeah. What he's saying is, as the sun rises, sure as it rises, it's going to set again. Amen?
Yes. Amen.
As sure as the wind blows in the south, it's going to return back to the north. And just as sure as the tide comes in, it's going to go back out. All these things happen in a continual motion, but they accomplish nothing. They all return to where they came from. They all return back to where they came. Amen. But I believe this passage pushes a little farther, because I believe thanks to the cross of Calvary, thanks to grace and the plan of salvation, we don't have to return from where we came. Amen.
Amen.
Paul said that when you become a creature in Christ, you become a new creature. He said, "All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new." Amen. That means every stronghold that had you, every chain that had you bound is now broken. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And it shakes our foundation. Now I believe the gospel in us, it becomes our testimony. And it becomes a big part of what we, as life, as Christians, our testimony plays a big part of that. Amen. If we just walked around and we didn't have a smile on our face, and we was always sad, people are going to think that what we have is not joy unspeakable but full of glory.
Amen.
Amen. And so, reading a little further, in 1 Corinthians, Paul said, because your actions, I believe they have to line up with your testimony. I don't believe I can tell somebody I'm a child of God and just act like the world. Amen. Lack of better words. But Paul said this in 1 Corinthians. He said, "Do ye not know that they which minister about holy things live of the things of the temple? And they which wait at the altar are partakers with the altar. Even so hath the Lord ordained that they which preach the gospel should live of the gospel."
All right.
Amen. We don't just preach it, but we got to live by it. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. He said, for that reason now, Jesus called us, and Sister Jane touched on this a little bit earlier, and it kind of made me feel in place when she did. But Jesus called us out from among the people to be separate. Amen. He didn't call us to fit in, to mix or to mingle. But he said we were a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, and a peculiar people. You can't be on fire for Jesus and a fool for the devil at the same time.
Amen.
Amen. It just doesn't work. Amen. So we have the gospel in us to set us free. I believe the gospel is what sets us free.
Yes,
and I believe good old sound doctrine keeps us there.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And so I believe whatever you find in the New Testament that could be considered doctrine will always, always ultimately go back to the gospel. Amen. It will always go back. The doctrine is an explanation interpretation or application of what we find in the gospel. Amen. But we have to be able to help people, not with just our words only, but our actions.
Amen.
Our actions should reciprocate our words. Amen.
That's exactly.
Amen. You can't, because your testimony and your character have to line up. You can't help somebody quit smoking while you're holding a cigarette. Amen. You can't teach somebody to love somebody else while you're displaying hatred towards somebody. Amen. We gotta love our brother, right? Amen. And so in Romans, and this is the argument I get with people a lot of times. It's not really an argument. People say, well, if you call upon the name of the Lord, the Bible says you'll be saved. And that's exactly what it says. That's the only verse you read. Amen. But if you read it in Romans chapter 10, amen, verse 13, he said, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Yeah.
He said, how then shall they call on him whom they have not believed? So you have to believe to call. Amen.
Yes.
And he said, and how shall they believe in whom they have not heard?
All right.
So you have to hear to be able to believe to be able to call.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
There's steps here. And he said, and how shall they hear without a preacher?
Amen.
So now you have to have a preacher to be able to hear, to be able to believe, to be able to call. Amen. And he said, and how shall they preach except they be sent?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So now he's saying that he sent a preacher that I may hear, that I may believe, that I may be able to call and have a chance to be saved. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So all this works together. All this works together. And he said, I'm sorry, I lost my place. He said, as it is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things. Amen. The gospel is not something that keeps us down.
That's
it's
right.
Not something that's depressing. The gospel
that's
is
right.
Uplifting. It should be a joy to live for God.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. We shouldn't be sad about what we've got. Amen. This is something that you can't get out of the world. You can't buy what we've got.
That's
amen.
Right.
And this is something that's precious. Amen. And people sometimes get entangled with their testimony. And the reason being is because they're worried about their life circumstances, amen. And I know because I've been in this predicament myself, to where sometimes you just let life get you down, and you're looking at now, you're not looking toward God, because nothing is too big for God. We heard a preacher say yesterday, you can't show me one place in the Bible where God stopped creating, amen. From the very beginning to the end, He was creating, amen. But we got to get away from the fancy words and spectacular events. I don't have a whole lot of big words, amen. Our testimony will go a long way with a lot of people, but you can't base your testimony and the gospel in you on the possessions and the stuff that you have.
Amen.
Amen. You've got to tell people what is, what was, and what is to come. Amen. You got to tell them where you came from, where God brought you to, and where He's taking you. Amen. That's going to carry a lot, because Paul said in 2 Corinthians 4:3, but if our gospel, he said, be hid, it is hid to them that are lost. We help no one when we silence. Amen. When we're silent, we help nobody. This is our gospel, he said. I could dwell all day on what I don't have, the things that are going wrong, my shoulder's messed up, I'm out of work, so I don't have a whole lot of money. Amen. And so I could dwell all day on that, or I could turn that around and use that as my testimony to say, hey, I may not have a whole lot of money, but I don't have a bill that's behind, amen. I may not have a whole lot of things, but I got a pantry full of food, amen. And my family's not doing that. I don't have a new truck, but I'm not walking, amen. So your testimony goes a long way. And if you give in to the devil, you're giving old slew foot what he asked for. And I heard a preacher one time say, you may be going through some bad stuff. And he said he was. And he said, it ain't like I want it. But he said, it ain't going to be like this for long, amen. Amen. Redemption's coming. Amen. Now I have to tell people what the Lord has done for me in my life, and you have to tell them what He's done for you in yours, because we can't help nobody with just sitting back being quiet. Amen.
No.
And in Philippians, he said, Philippians 1:27, he said, only let your conversation be as it becometh the gospel of Christ.
Yes.
Amen. That whether I come see you or else be absent, I may hear of your affairs, that you stand fast in one mind. I'm sorry, one mind, one spirit, striving together for the faith of the gospel. Stop letting distraction silence you, amen. Stand fast in one spirit, with one mind, striving together for the gospel of Jesus Christ. First Timothy, and I'm wrapping up. First Timothy, he said, now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. He already knew that this day would come. The gospel and the doctrine work side by side to save which is lost. But you can't water it down, amen. You can't leave parts out because as convenient as it may be to sugarcoat the word of God, you never help nobody by doctoring the doctrine. Amen. So you go down to verse 6. He said, if thou put the brethren in remembrance of these things, thou shalt be a good minister of Jesus Christ, nourished up in the words of faith and of good doctrine, whereunto thou hast been attained. Let your testimony, let your voice ring out. Don't be silenced by the lying whispers of the devil, because if you let him, he's going to get inside your head. Amen. Amen. Let's go out. Let's win some souls for Jesus. Amen. Y'all give the Lord a hand clap.